The miniature gauge engines were talking about the day's events one night when Mike popped a question.
Have you guys noticed that Mr. Fergus Duncan has been in charge of our railway for many years?
Ah, so, what's your point, Mike?
The Northwestern Railway changes their controllers every so often this year. Mr. Melvin is in charge, and just recently, Mr. Percival handed reins to his son, Mr. Langley. So why hasn't Mr. Fergus given the role of the controller to his daughter, Lucy Duncan?
Well, Mike, you do have a point, though. Don't forget.
Lucy is our media and public communication manager.
Besides, Mike, what will I be doing if I retire this quick?
Drink yourself into a stupor.
Mike! Well, Mike, since you cracked the first joke of the day, guess what you're going to be doing? Pulling the Tea Time Express.
Booger!
As for the rest of you, normal jobs. Oh, Sigrid, I need you to take Mike's goods train, since he's going to be doing, you know, the regular passenger service.
Why, of course, sir. I will do it.
Early the next morning, Mike coupled up to the Tea Time Express, and he was furious.
Passengers? Why did I open my big mouth?
Oh, maybe because you're too hot-headed, Mike?
No one asked you, Bert.
And no one asked you to say those awful things to Mr. Duncan. His feelings are probably hurt right now.
Sydney!
It's Sigrid, you imbecile.
Whatever. I feel that it's time for Duncan here to retire and enjoy his retirement in some... What was that word Duck used when he was talking about one of the passengers? Oh, a mental institution.
Both Sigrid and Bert were horrified. No engine had ever disrespected Mr. Duncan at all like that.
Mike, the red engine.
Oh, you really done it this time now, Mike?
Did I hear you correctly? I should spend my retirement in... Of all places, a mental institution?
As a matter of fact, sir, I did.
First the drinking joke, and now this. You really have no respect for your superiors, do you, Mike? Jock will head this train. You can go back to your sedge, where I can talk to you later.
Oh, come on!
Later that night, Mr. Duncan spoke severely to Mike.
I will not be disrespected in front of paying customers, nor will I be disrespected in front of my engines. Listen to me, Mike. You will do as you're told. Do you understand?
No, sir.
My best bet, Mike, is to keep quiet and don't piss off Mr. Duncan any further.
I understand what you are saying, though I don't understand why you can't just live the rest of your days at home. The world is changing, and if we are able to adapt to it, so can you!
Mr. Duncan's face went redder than Mike's paintwork. But before he could yell at Mike, a voice was heard in the distance.
I couldn't agree more with Mike, although he should have said it in a better way. Dad.
It was Mr. Duncan's daughter, Lucy Duncan, with a gentleman right beside her.
I hated going around your back like this, but I had no choice. You are no longer empowered by the board of directors. I've been chosen to be in charge. Dad, you need to retire, and now, and you even know that yourself. You have 2 weeks to clean out your office, and after that, you're no longer in power.
Yes! My dream came true!
Now is not the time, Mike.
Jock's right, Mike. You're not out of the woods yet. Because of this, we will be having a little talk about disrespect. As for the rest of you all, we'll discuss tomorrow morning the plans and new operations for this year. My own flesh and blood betrays me like this. I will not sit on my rear end and play golf for 20 years. I love working for this railway, whether you like it or not. I'm sorry, Dad, but it's the way that the board wanted it. Then mark my words, it will not be over.
And indeed, Mr. Duncan was right.